Good afternoon, everyone. I will be presenting the story of my school, Haji Public School, which was set up by my family in 2009 in our ancestral village. And it's a quick photo story because, you know, the pictures will show you better how it goes. If we can just start the presentation, I can take you to the story. So we run under the Haji Education Foundation, which is a trust that we started just to focus on the school, to gather scholarships for the children. The aim was to start a good quality school in a village that has not seen education for, I would say, about 30 years. There are government schools present, but the level of education is negligent. It is horrific. And since I grew up seeing my cousins and friends in the village with absolutely nothing in terms of education or learning, we wanted to do a really big change in terms of long term, how can we affect the future. And education, of course, is the only way and the most powerful way. So we run under the Haji Education Foundation. This is my school. This is my village. This is about 2 minutes from my home. It's all slopes. It's a mountain region. We're in Dora district of Jammu and Kashmir, very far away from the valley. We are in the mountains that surround the Kashmir Valley. People often confuse us for being in Kashmir, which is, oh, thank you. All right. We are not from the Kashmir Valley, but we are culturally similar. We are Paharis. Very remote areas. We don't have coverage for health or education or banks or anything, and everything has to happen on foot. So this is the last road stop where I'm standing, and across the Chenab, the red circle is where my village is. This is a photo. This is how it would look to you if I go there today. So I cross the town over here. It's called Premnagar. There's a footbridge over the Chenab. And then it's about 8 kilometers up on foot or on horseback. And this is how we go. These are my volunteers coming up. My school runs on volunteers. So it's a very nice scenic route. There are own horses. They're well trained. There's no worry. It looks dangerous, but it's actually not. We started in 2009. And these are my first two classes. This is my own bedroom. We didn't have a building at the time. So it would be the school in the morning, and in the evening we would, you know, it would switch back to our house. And these kids, I'm very proud to say today, they're the senior most class. One of our students has written his board exam today, the 8th board. And they continue to be our senior most class. This is the building as it is today. So from no building, this is what we've been able to build. As you can see, it's cut into the mountain because there is no plain in the Dora district. There is no plain ground at all. Completely built by the community. The bricks are built by our men and women. The materials are brought up on horseback, or they carry up the tin sheets, the windows, the iron bars, everything built by our villagers. So it's a very, it has to be a deep community project. This is the school ground. So again, these are places we've carved out. I'm just going to show you the facilities, what we've been able to do just by using the villagers' help, by putting in a little effort on our part. It has to come from us. The point of my whole presentation at the end would be that, you know, we cannot depend on the government or other people to do it. If you have to do something, you know, get the people of the area involved, and anything is possible, really. So this was my cornfield, and now it's a school playground, and I feel it's being used much better. We have, you know, a lot of help coming in from people online. A lot of you have helped me. I've seen some people I've met on Twitter, or just folks who've sent in a lot of materials for the school: toys, games, computers, laptops, uniforms. A lot of it has come from very kind strangers who I've even never met. We have, you know, happy children. The one thing that keeps me going and keeps the volunteers going, our kids are very happy and they're very bright. And I feel if this chance is given to kids across the country in an environment where you would like to learn and you're having fun, you will always see smiling kids across. You know, simple things like a pull-up bar, which is a couple of ₹100 on Amazon, or puzzles, and just so much learning and just fun and a lot of other things. I never had a lot of this in my school. My school wasn't so much fun, but we tried to. This is something I'm very proud of. Azen was with us, Azen Linares, for 4 years. And he was a climber, and he set this up, an indoor climbing wall. And our girls and boys were Pahadi, so of course we're good climbers. And we set them on the walls right from kindergarten. From LKG, we let them get on the walls. They are extremely good climbers with good coaching. They can really go far. In fact, this year, for the first time, I entered my team in the North Zone climbing contest. And two of my youngest girls won medals for Jammu and Kashmir. And they had never stepped out of the village before. It was really exciting. I think Shruti is here. Shruti has helped us with our climbing as well. Thank you. Again, you will see the girls and boys participate equally, equally enthusiastically. Their parents, they support them as much or more than I've seen city parents allowing girls. There are these city notions of gender construct. Girls should not play cricket and girls should probably do home science, which is so ridiculous in the village because everyone does everything. And I feel this is true for many villages across. You don't have the gender biases. Everyone does all the work, housework, cooking, cleaning, animals, fire, whatever. Everything is done by everyone, and we've taken that into the school. I never had to face resistance in terms of can girls do this or that. And the boys are very keen. It's like it's not even a thing. They don't even think anymore that it's only for us or only for the girls, because they're always pulling, and we have co-ed teams, or we have equal participation in absolutely everything. Again, like I said, just happy kids. We have a lot of fun. They're, of course, the least happiest when they're studying, but they're great at everything else, as all kids are. Sports kid from, people in Bangalore. Culture, different religions. We have all sorts of, that is not a problem in villages, I feel. It becomes ugly when you come into the city or, I don't know. This has never been a problem. Okay, we don't have, like I said, we don't have plain ground in the village. So for our sports day, we need a playing ground. We need to go up 3,000 feet to Shrine, which is the meadow on top, and that's where we do our sports day every year. So we go up maybe 2-3 hours in the morning, we draw the lines, and then the kids play all day at 10,500 feet. And just, again, pictures from the school of girls and boys. This is something that is a bedrock of my school, really, the volunteer program, where young men and women like yourself, from across India, from other countries, we've also had people coming in. They spend a minimum of 3 to 4 months. A lot of times, because they like it there, they extend. And we've had a lot of repeat volunteers who've come back the next year, or some of them come back twice or thrice and stay on. It has to be 3 months. You have to be serious. You have to really work hard on the kids. And I can really tell within a week if a volunteer has come for a holiday or if he's come to teach. He or she has come to teach. And we have asked some volunteers to leave because they had come for a Himalayan stay, which was not the purpose of my volunteer program. And the kids can make out as well. Kids are very perceptive. If you give them your 100%, you will really see them responding so well. Oh, we had the Arsenal International Junior Coach from Kuwait come in to teach our kids for a bit. She has sent tons of Arsenal merchandise, used shoes from affluent kids in the Gulf, but very usable, and our kids really are using them well. We run on the local staff that I have. They of course have to manage the lower classes. Very hardworking group, but they come. The weakness for them would be that they've studied in the government schools in the past 20 years or so, and their level of learning is really not so high. So we keep training them, but they're only capable of handling up to maybe the kindergarten or first grade. And then the volunteers have to come in to do good teaching. The only reason I am here today is because people know of me on the internet or know about the school. And so I'm just, I'm always having like a barrage of tweets and posts on Facebook, on Twitter. We've been covered by a lot of good websites. We got a lot of coverage in 2012. One of our videos came out. At the end of the day, this is why we do it, because I'm seeing what has happened with the kids. I told you the kids joined us in 2009, and I've seen them grow over the years. I've seen their siblings join in, and these are all children of my cousins or my friends who I've grown up with. So kind of my children, an extension. Everyone in the village is related to me. That's how villages work. This is the story of the school. What I'm trying to present over here is that this is what I've done with my family, so it's possible. I had a rich uncle who can pump the money in. I have my family who is based in the village and who knows the people and can work it. And the idea really was that we start this in our village and maybe other people see us and continue doing the same thing in their villages or wherever they have, wherever they can reach out to. I don't know how many of you are from villages or your families are from villages, but if you can, if you have the time, either start something on your own. I know time and the money, it's a lot of money, so if you have some rich relatives that always helps, but you need the effort. You can join organizations that are already providing the infrastructure and just join them and give your time to teach well, and teach in a very broad-minded, open way, teach tolerance, teach learning, rather than this is in the book and this is patriotism and this is that's not natural. Teach them things about life, about learning, about human beings, kindness, and that is really what will help in the long run. That's the story of Haji Public School.